MR Tween Machine is a script for Moho that helps make it easy to control inbetweens in animation. If you are not familiar with this script at all, I recommend first watching two videos for the previous versions. Let me briefly remind you how the script has evolved. The first version has only one slider that could blend the values of two neighboring keys in the current frame. In the second version, there were already two sliders. The second slider could blend the values of the current frame with the values of the neighboring keys. That is, it could reduce the difference between keyframes. And this approach became more universal. And finally, the new third version. Attention spoiler! The third version has a third slider. Thanks for watching, subscribe to the channel! Just kidding! Actually, the third slider is there, but it's definitely not the only addition. The third version is literally a hybrid of Tween Machine and my other script key motion. Let's now look at all the new possibilities. Now the script works only as a floating panel and not as a regular tool. This means the script is supported by Moho starting from 14.1. The third slider. Unlike the second slider, which reduces the difference between values, the third one increases it. This will be useful when you want, for example, to strengthen anticipation or overshoot relative to the neighboring key. Tween Machine can also be used in rigging to control the movement speed of different parts of a character relative to each other in smart bones. The second slider could only reduce speed, but now you can also increase it, which makes this control complete. The Use Playback Range option allows blended values between the start and end frames of the playback range instead of neighboring keys. This allows you to blend current pose with any other poses on the timeline. When this option is enabled, panel provides a whole set of functions that work with the playback range. All these functions can work with both points and bones. Range Edit Mode, which works just like in the new version of MR Pro's tool. In this mode, the changes you make with the sliders will be applied to the entire playback range with smooth in and out. For example, you can increase the difference between the current pose and another one without ruining the existing in-betweens. The Smooth In-Out option creates additional emphasis on acceleration and deceleration. The ability to strengthen or weaken motion inside the range. I took the idea of the scale function from the key motion script and improved it, so that the changes occur relatively to the movement from the start of the range to the end. This way, changes in the animation channel will always have a correct in and out. This is a very simple way, for example, to strengthen anticipation or overshoot, or to tame overly wide amplitudes. You can control how intense this will be. This can also be very useful in adjusting cycles. The ability to compress animation channels to one side or to several sides at once. Compressing left or right makes it possible to increase acceleration or deceleration. This is very convenient when the character movement is very even and they stop too abruptly. Just compress the channel several times to get rid of monotony in the motion. Here's how it looks in the motion graph. If you press the buttons without, the compression will occur not along the entire range, but from the playhead position to the end of the range on the chosen side. You can also compress channels simultaneously to both sides, towards the middle of the range, and to both sides and the middle at the same time. You can use Alt plus click for all compression buttons when you need to compress from the frame where the playhead is located. The ability to smooth animation channels. The idea was taken from key motion, but the algorithm is different and works much better. If you encounter problematic spacing in your animation, smoothing the channels will help calm and even things out. But be careful, smoothing ranges that are too large can flatten desirable peaks in motion and reduce amplitudes. The best approach for all these buttons is when you know what you are doing and work individually with small ranges to have full control. The ability to bake animation in the selected range. The interval used for baking is the same as for Smart Bake. If your character uses arms or legs on targets, when baking, they will receive the actual values, and after detaching from the target, they will keep their position. It will also help you correctly use compression and smoothing on targeted knees or elbows. I recommend the following order of actions when you need to make motion softer with a smooth stop. Step 1. Bake the frames inside the range so the all bones or points have the keys on the same frames. Step 2. Smooth the channels until the movement becomes more stable but does not change too much. Step 3. Compress the movement toward deceleration. Compression and smoothing can be applied to different bones with different intensity. This can create nice desynchronization during the stop, which makes the movement more natural. Tween Machine can now synchronize point settings with MR Animate Points tool, understand its modes and isolated layers. Settings for channels are now placed on the main panel for faster access. Also, new buttons were added so you can choose exactly what you want to work with. Bones, points, camera, layer, and now stroke exposure is also supported. All these functions are not about clicking one button and making the animation better. These functions help the animator work easier and faster and fully control the process. Let me know in the comments if the script was useful to you.